In this tutorial, we'll show you how to create data maps and move data from consolidated strategic models to planning applications. With Smart Push enabled, you can now push data between planning and strategic models using a UI-driven data mapping process and data transfer functionality that does not require scripting. Let's begin by creating a data map. You create data maps to map dimensions between a source planning application, strategic model, or strategic consolidation model, and a target planning application, reporting application, or strategic model. Enter a unique name for your data map. Descriptions are optional. Then, select the source and target. In this example, I'm selecting my consolidation model as a source and the OEP_FS as a target planning cube. You can also map a consolidated strategic model to a reporting cube if you want to run reports against consolidated data in planning. Next, I'll start mapping dimensions. Click the Select link under each dimension to open Member Selector. You can search for specific members or locate members using the member list. I'll quickly complete member selections for a few dimensions. I'll map the time source dimension to the year's target dimension. Optionally, on this page, you can leave member selections at the default or root level and specify mappings in the Edit Data Map dialog box. For each dimension, you can click the Map link to open the Edit Data Map dialog box. Let's walk through the tabs in the Edit Data Map dialog box. Basic info includes the name and description of your data map. It also lists the source and target. Source selection displays a filtered point of view of your source members. Here are the dimensions with members I've selected. Target selection displays your target member options. Notice that account lists members at the root level. When you change member selections, you must apply the same change on the map tabs and the source and target selection tabs. I'll also make sure that my member mappings are consistent between the dimension tabs and the source and target selection tabs. When selecting members, you can use the drop-down list to select from a filtered list. The contents of the filtered list are based on selections on these two tabs. Similarly, I'll enter mappings for business case and scenario. Let's take a look at my accounts.
Data maps automatically map same name dimension members and allows you to define the mapping between other dimension members. You can define complex mappings to or from a single member, to or from multiple members.
After I selected source account members, the system identifies, checks, compares, and selects account names and the target. While auto-mapping can be a time saver, you can still make changes to the target selections in this tab. Because I have my target selection for accounts set to the root level, I can choose from all the accounts available in my cube. I map the time dimension in my model to the year's dimension in my cube. Unmapped dimensions are read-only in this dialog box. If you need to make changes to unmapped dimensions, close this dialog box and make your selections here. I'll quickly select members for the unmapped dimensions. You can also make additional changes to your mappings here. Here are the updated mappings. Here's my source, target, and the number of members mapped per dimension. After making changes, save and close the data map. Here's my data map. The Actions menu allows you to edit, duplicate, delete, or synchronize the data map by using your data map selections. Let's take a look at the source and target POV we'll be working with before pushing data. Here is the point of view in my source consolidated strategic model. Here is the data point of view of my source planning application. Next, I'll associate my data map with the models in the consolidation and specify that the data map and smart push should execute when I run the consolidation. I'll set the percentage of the child model to be consolidated to 100%. Then, I'll set a data map for the consolidated model. The data map should be assigned at the parent level so that the consolidated data at the parent level is moved to planning. Select Run on Consolidate to make sure that the data map and smart push process are run when you open and check out the consolidation model. I'll clear selections for the workshop child to make sure we run only the data map associated at the parent level. Now, I'll run the consolidation and move data using smart push. You can choose to run the consolidation process only, or run the consolidation process and push data from the consolidation model into planning. I'll run and push data. You can select a different target version when you run the data map. In this case, I'm leaving it blank so that it will take the version specified in the data map. Smart push always clears data in the target region before moving new data. Let's go to Job Scheduler to review the run status. Optionally, you can set run times for data maps in Job Scheduler. After the job is completed, I'll verify that the data was moved to planning. Data was successfully moved to my planning application. After creating a data map, you can export it to a file, make changes to it using Excel, and import it into your application. The exported file displays tabs similar to the Edit Data Map dialog box. For more information on importing data maps, visit the Oracle Planning and Budgeting Cloud Help Center
and view the Using Excel Data Maps for Moving Data Between Planning Cubes and Strategic Models tutorial.
In this tutorial, you learned how to create data maps and move data from consolidated strategic models to planning applications. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.